We are the Scorpions. Into this Legends on Film.
Hello.
Hey! Hot and heavy!
Yeah!
The early days, to have gigs, that was the most important thing, you know. And when we played outside, let's say 20 kilometers outside of Hanover, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, you know, for us that was going on tour. It was very important to have an Echo Hell machine because it was not so easy for a German singer to sing in English, you know. It was a tough thing to do. So we heard the records, you know, the way it sounded, the way we played it, you know. I was singing what I understood from the record, you know. I was just singing like, I got you, man, Sam, running, I'll tell you, baby, right. It sounded pretty good, you know, with a lot of hell on it, but without, I was in trouble, I tell you. Going to Hamburg, meeting Connie Plank, that was the first time we saw what's happening in a real studio.
Connie came immediately to us, said, I want to produce the guys. Oh, and then we did the first album called Lonesome Crow, and we did it in 6 days only, including
mixing. Soundcheck.
And soundcheck and mixing, yeah.
It was really tough to get gigs, you know, I mean, to play in a club and stuff, okay, but we really wanted to play in front of a serious crowd. So we called up agencies, you know, and clubs and stuff, and some guys were with a pen making some noise on the table, you know. We did something, it sounded like a big office, you know. Well, we have this band here, you know, Thin Lizzy, yeah, and UFO, yeah. And yeah, this new band from Germany, you know, still available, the Scorpion. There is no dream that you can
control. You're looking for love. Our equipment was built, set up, everything, and then UFO came and said, hey guys, excuse us. But the problem is, our guitar player is still in England because he forgot his passport. Is it possible that you can borrow us your guitar player? My brother played with us, with Scorpions, then he changed a little bit to make it not too obvious. And then he went back with UFO on stage. And Phil Mock, he was going like, oh, this guy is very good, and he making an offer.
I was totally frustrated, you know. I mean, I could understand, of course, it was a great offer for Michael. And we all said, hey, good luck. And everybody, I mean, Rudolf and me, I think we went to the airport and say, waved him goodbye, here he goes, off to London. We say, hey, man, what can we say? But for us, you know, that's it. He goes Scorpions, you know. Drove a million miles, gambling roots, my life. Our old record company, when Michael left, they didn't believe in the band anymore. They fired us. We had kind of break for a few months, and one day Rudolf was calling. Somehow he found Uli Roth and Francis, Jung and Achim, the keyboard player at the time, and we were the old guys from Scorpions, you know, and we said, okay, we come over there, check them out. And they said, oh, well, you can join us. Oh, we said, oh, down road, yeah. Mm-hmm. At least we were the guys with the record out,
yeah.
And we said, hey, I mean, we played some serious stuff already. Why don't you join us?
Here I am! Rock you like a hurricane! Here I am! Rock you like a hurricane! Here I am!
Got that with Autobahn, they were very big in America. But there was never ever a hard rock or heavy metal band coming out of Germany. We were knocking at the doors in the world, hey, here are the Scorpions. And they said, the who?
Connie Plank, we came to him and said, Connie, we want to play in America. He said, you want to play in America? You know how many good bands are in America happening? He said, anyway, you have to believe in yourself and you can play there. And he said, ha, 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 ha.
With our music, we crashed the doors and said, hey, here we are and play. And we played everywhere. You know, that was our idea. Today, I think there are a lot of good bands coming out of Germany, and if the band is good enough, they have the chance to go to Paris, to LA, to Moscow. And when we played the Moscow Music Peace Festival in August, 2 days in front of 100,000 Russian kids every day, I mean, that really proves that rock and roll, this music, is such an international language, is such a powerful force, a great bridge between continents, between cultures, to bring the people from east and west, from north and south, all over the world, bring them closer together.
As long as we believe in love.
Yeah. Well, some years ago, the Germans came to France with tanks. Now the Germans are coming with guitars.
As long as we believe in love.
So for us, the philosophy is, whatever we do today, if we do it right, then tomorrow is going to be no problem.
Then give peace a chance.
One more chance to start.